This video is a continuation of the first video we examined, just highlighting the different instructor annotation tools that are available to you through D2L. And as always, if you ever have questions, you can email us at d2lhelp@okcu.edu. Today I want to examine the highlight tool and the pen tool, and these are the first tools that we can use when you're marking a student's assignment and giving them some feedback. To do that, what you're going to do is access the assignment that you need for the student. And there's two ways to highlight. One is you can highlight text like I'm doing now. And when you highlight the text, the very first box with the A in the white background, that's your highlight tool. You can click that and it highlights the text that you have highlighted on the student's paper. This snaps to the text that is existing in the document, so you don't have to worry about going crazy or getting out of whack. If you don't like what you highlighted, you decided that no, this was okay, click that text and then click the trash can, and that will eliminate that particular annotation. Or the other way that you can highlight text is by clicking the little down arrow on the pen and choose highlight. This brings up a toolbar now that you can use as part of your highlighting inside the student text. This time though, all of the highlighting is going to be freeform. Choose your color on the leftmost box and drag, click and drag across the things that you want to bring attention to. So you can see here that my mouse kind of wiggled all over the place. It was not a perfect fit. Once I've done the highlighting, if I decide I don't like it or I feel that it is okay and I don't need to call attention to it, click the pen icon and then click on the annotation that you made, and that brings up the trash can option so that you can delete it. So I'm going to click back into the highlighter, and now I'm going to show you that you can highlight an entire block of text by holding down your left mouse button and dragging the highlighter all the way across. So in this case, I have my point of a highlighter turned on and the box of the highlighter turned on. So that gives me this sort of interesting slanted color shape. But if I turned off that actual highlight tip, then I would have a box of highlighted material. So if there's an entire paragraph that you want to draw attention to for a student, you can highlight that entire paragraph instead of just the lines. And again, to delete anything, click that icon so that it's turned off, click the annotation you just made, and choose to delete. The last thing I want to show you today is the pen tool, and it works very similar to the highlighter tool. The very first option is the color of the pen that you're going to use. That next one, that open box, is the color of the box behind the pen. Now, this works with a mouse hold, so you have to click and hold down the left key, the left click on your mouse, and then spell out what it is that you want to say to your students. So I'm trying to say, come see me. That's going to take a lot of effort using my mouse. However, if I want to highlight different parts of a paragraph, I can do that. When I activate the box fill, it does this. It works just like the highlighter one did, where you can drag and undo the whole box. With both the highlighter and the pen, you can choose the opacity and you can choose the width of the tool, how it comes out when you click and hold. And then this last option here changes the view of what you have highlighted through different things. So the ones that I've chosen here, it's very, very subtle, but there is a difference between the background and the choices that I've made. But it will lighten, it will darken, it will do some different things like that. You can always go back to normal. It brings back the original. So to review, we're looking at the pen tool and the highlight tool inside of the instructor annotation tool in D2L.